There was a really interesting article published recently in the Frontiers of Human Neuroscience, and I'll read the title to you. It's a bit long, so bear with me. Imprinting, expanding the extra-pharmacological model of psychedelic drug action to incorporate delayed influences of sets and setting. And this was published in July 18th, 2023. Now, what's fascinating about this article is that it showed that if someone had a high level of media exposure before their therapy session, that it actually overpowered the intention setting process. And for those participants who decreased the use of media prior to their sessions, they had a more robust experience. And in particular, they could use that intention tool that I've spoken about previously. So this is one of the important things. Our minds are like our digestive system, right? So whatever you eat, it will eventually become a part of you. Proteins, carbohydrates, glucose, fatty acids, all of that comes from our food and eventually becomes a part of our body. Similarly, I think the things that we consume mentally, whether it's books, whether it's social media, whether it's news, whether it's this video, all of this will play a building block in our psyche. So, before someone undergoes a ketamine therapy at our clinic, we have them prepare mentally. This may look like taking a break from violent movies, from horror movies, from that legal thriller crime show that you may love to watch. Because all of that, and especially a lot of it, might show up during the ketamine therapy. It reminds me of one patient that we had who was watching Grey's Anatomy, like literally the morning before the infusion. And during the session, the patient reported a lot of Grey's Anatomy scenes were coming up, and it was a little bit intense for that person. So be really mindful of what you're consuming, not only via your mouth and the foods we eat, but also mentally. All of these things eventually do become a building block to our psyche.